Were you trying to get crazy with this thing? Don't you know I'm loco?
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to Hashtag PVT. We are coming at you live from Society Tool for a co-working community, providing a productive work environment for RGV entrepreneurs, helping people ditch the home office and coffee shop for a more productive environment with other mobile workers. Look at that beautiful, beautiful scenery right there.
Stunning.
It's one of the most beautiful buildings in the city of Edinburgh, and you can be in here with us. And look, there's a bar right there. You can have drinks with your clients or employees.
Or co-workers?
Yeah, and they have a kitchen. They have a dining room. It is awesome. It's situated in the heart of Edinburgh's historic downtown district. Our space is ready to accommodate businesses of all sizes. Come on over and get a tour with Renee. One sexy lady. It's 956.
Whoa. He's not kidding.
I'm not kidding. And 956-887-1143. And she is very, very awesome. And she will show you around. And you'll probably end up getting a little office space right here with us. And you'll be our neighbors, you know. And we'd also want to thank Dr. T's Primary Care for Men and Women. If you feel sluggish, tired, gain weight, and you're looking for a primary care clinic to help improve your quality of life, Dr. T's Primary Care for Men and Women. They handle your primary care needs. They got a new number. 956-441-2188 is their original number. And they also have another number that we're going to show to you right now. 1-855-771-1650. And they have a website, drtees.com. All right? Get on it. Y pues tú sabes, es summer. Y pues ya, you know, you want to do a little extra curricular activity, dar una revolqueada con la baby dolly, pues chihuahua, se te juele el viro por la ventana y le chingada, entonces pedo con este jale de, no me te esquinea y te ayuda. And your wife will be cooking you breakfast again in no time because you gave her a little something. All right.
And so, as we've always said, trying to make it a catchphrase, you go from limp to blimp.
Yeah.
Cannons on fire.
Dr. T's Primary Care for Men and Women. Also, we want to thank Rhodey's Country Fried Chicken,
Eagle Pass.
Oh, yeah. We want to thank Rhodey because Riley Los Hilitos went up there and performed, and we never put up the pictures. We need to get them. We're going to put them up, Rick, all right? So he took care of Riley Los Hilitos, les dio tray de gizzards y de pollo. No me salieron.
Is he coming down soon?
He's coming down July for his birthday. So he's going to be here on the show, Rick and his kids, and it's going to be awesome. It'll be in the middle of July. Old-fashioned country cooking. Mira cómo se ve el pollo ese, Raymond. Hijo de su. Cuando vayan a Eagle Pass, caile a Rick Rhodey's ahí. Rhodey's Country Fried Chicken, bro.
Pa' la muela picada.
Hombre, caile la boca, papa. Asústame one time. Located 1910 El Indio Highway, fastest drive-thru in Texas. They got fish and shrimp, hot dogs, and chicken fried steak. Y no, hombre, tiene una special sauce que... No, hombre, qué barro. It's got a recipe, que it's under lock and key. Nobody can get it. So give him a call.
Ni Colonel Sanders trae nada.
No, no trae nada. Colonel Sanders, carnal. Rick Rhodey's es el mero mero ahí en Eagle Pass.
We call him Ravishing Rick Rhodey's.
Yeah.
He's simply Ravishing.
Ravishing Rick Rhodey's. Y ojalá que un día se haga un Rhodey's aquí en el Valle, porque no me cállate la boca.
We need it.
It's going to be fantastic. Y le vamos a caer todos los días, papá. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, before we get to the mayhem and the destruction and disastrous, tornadoes and, and what is it, natural disasters.
Yeah.
We're going to let you know that we are going to be all over the place with Hashtag PBT. Wow. Starting this Friday, we're going to be at the show con Chris Perez and, of course, Carlito and Rudy from La Mafia and
Joey Jams.
It's the Grupo Metal. And we have a table. Chaz is going to be there. Jax is going to be there.
A huevo.
Becky Lee Meza Burden, who was Selena, the little girl Selena in the movie, she's going to be sitting there with us. So if you've never met her and you want to take a picture with her, she'll be there with us as well. So make sure to go out there to Mission, Texas and check us out. And it's at the food truck. You guys have performed there, right, guys? At the food truck park there in Mission?
Oh, yeah, man.
Yeah, I performed there.
Weren't you there with Chingo Bling or something like that?
Yeah, se hizo un despapalle, bro. Ya sabes.
Y hay comida para comprar y mesa. Is it a good place to do shows, man?
It's awesome for outdoor festivals, like, because it's pretty neat, man. But, like, for comedy, I like an enclosed venue mejor. Sí.
Why is that?
For rock?
Because los laughter se va para afuera.
Yeah.
Se va para arriba.
Well, speaking of comedy, did you hear that Bill Burr is going to play, like, Boston's Fenway Park?
Yeah.
He's gonna fill that stadium up.
Yeah, dude. Fluffy just did Dodger Stadium también.
See,
and then, yeah, Kevin Hart did Philadelphia Stadium. Yeah,
that's amazing. Comedians filling up stadiums, dude. Whoever heard of that, dude?
Comedy is a hot commodity.
Yeah, and it's the comedians. Well, I mean, Bill Burr is one of those guys that pushes the envelope. He doesn't really care about all the sensitive bullshit going on.
Nah, he's got you up in your face about it.
Yeah, aggressive. He's got that Boston attitude, you know.
And, yeah.
So I wouldn't mind going to that show, dude. That's going to be awesome. Also, we're going to be July 2nd. I will be the MC in Rio Grande at Freedom Fest con el Grupo Sólido, Signo. Chris Perez will be there as well. A free event for all the family and fireworks show. Put that poster up again, baby, so we can see a little bit
of
it.
Do you want to do the commercial?
Okay. You know what? We'll do the commercial. Go ahead and put it up. Let's check it out. Check this out, ladies and gentlemen.
Rio Grande City Freedom Fest, Saturday, July 2nd at the Basilio Villarreal Park, with T-ball and softball tournament, a barbecue cook-off, food and craft vendors, free kiddie rides, with a massive fireworks show with Grupo Signo, with special guest Chris Perez, Rio Grande's very own Grupo Sólido, Latin Vibe, y Grupo Inevitable. Rio Grande City Freedom Fest, Saturday, July 2nd. Bring the whole family. Free for all ages. Rio Grande City's gonna hit it out of the ballpark.
Rio Grande City Freedom Fest!
How many takes did it take for you to do that swing, bro?
Oye, bro, le pegué a la cerca, carnal. Sí, wow. Do we have that video clip or no?
I don't. Think so. Okay, not here.
It got lost.
Mr. Perfect.
I have video proof.
Está como Uncle Rico, así como I bet you I can throw this football across that mountain.
Dr. T's treatment.
Oh, fíjate que I went up there and I swung and missed like 5 times,
yeah.
Dude.
Yeah, you did.
And I was pretty embarrassed, right? And I got off, and then Rolo from Solido went up, and he missed, and I said, "Thanks for making me look good, dude," right? And so then they said, "Hey, Rock," he hit one of them. And so they said, "Hey, Rock, you need to hit a ball because we need you to hit a ball for the video, right?"
Did they do it underhand?
No, hombre, carnal. Le pegué 3 in a row, carnal.
Eso.
No, hombre.
Yeah, you did.
Sí. Tengo proof, carnal.
Yeah, I videotaped every single one of them.
And then did you look at the camera and say, "Simply perfect"?
Uh-huh. Did you do the gum?
Yeah, so. Oye, Charlie, trae los ojitos que te miras bien chato. You don't even smoke, though.
I know.
You don't even smoke.
High. It's a natural look.
Yeah.
He's got a natural aura, high. Bro.
That's the aura it's going to be.
So that's going to be July 2nd, Rio Grande City, ladies and gentlemen. Lleva toda la familia. Parece que vamos a llevar el primo Cheo también. Vamos a tener una mesa ahí con él. July 30th, Elida Fest in Mercedes. We're going to be there as well. And Elida and her husband will be here the first week of July. They'll be here in the studios, and we'll be talking to them. It'll be fantastic, and it's going to be beautiful and awesome. And we want everybody to join us, okay? And so those are the events. And if you want PVT to be part of your event, you need to give us a call. Or if you want to advertise with us, you can also give us a call or a text at 956-641-3241. And we want to welcome a brand new sponsor from Brenham, Texas.
He is
a sponsor on Tuesday nights. So Top Floor Cars, classic and used.
Thank you.
Brenham, Texas. Check out the video. Tienen unos carritos, man. They buy, sell, and trade all over the United States of America.
Yeah.
Wow. Mala toquita esa, papa.
Sústame
one time.
Pero quema or nada.
And they deliver. If you buy one of their cars online, one of their classic cars, they will deliver it to your house, and you will have it in your garage. And look at that.
That's a beautiful truck.
I love those old cars, man. Those old trucks, dude. Those were built tough. I mean, eran de fierro, papá.
Big time.
You could crash four times and not even feel it.
Y no es de plástico como era, bro. Those are amazing. So thank you, Top Floor Cars. They're not part of the Wednesday programming. They're part of the Tuesday night programming. So we still have space for your business. If you want to be on Tuesday or Thursday, we have a number you need to call. 956-641-6241. And then we put all the details.
3241.
Oh, 32. What did I say?
6241. Okay,
3241.
Yes, sir.
And we have space for you and your business and your project. All right? All right. And your product. Okay, so let's go to Jax Phoenix. What we're going to do with Jax Phoenix, he's going to be on the chat zone, ladies and gentlemen. And we want to ask all of you, okay, worldwide, to ask an awkward question, okay, for the guys, all right? So we're going to be looking for awkward questions. So, Jax, how you doing, bro?
¿Cómo estamos, Dad?
¿Cómo estamos, carnal?
Fíjate que I'm really happy to be here today. I was telling you guys before I started the show how blessed I feel because before, when I used to just be a hashtag PBT fan, watching from home, I remember when Raymond and Mario would come into the show, those were one of my favorite. I mean, I love all your shows, but those were one of my favorite shows coming on because these guys have so much funny stuff to talk about, man. And and people, fans, stay tuned because we have a great show for you guys, but I need those awkward questions for them because I do want to ask them some awkward stuff and see what we can get out of them.
Yeah.
And we'll give you some shout outs. And remember, I'm the gatekeeper in the chat zone. I'm Jax Phoenix. Yeah. Thank you for having me, Dad. I'm happy.
Man. I am too, man.
Chaz, thank you for being
these
here.
These guys, Raymond and Mario, are professional cagapalos, man.
Professional.
That's what we like.
Licensed and certified.
Yeah, licensed, certified. Son masters y PhDs y la chingada. Todo ese pedo, ¿entiendes?
Y un shout out para producer Riley también.
Yeah. And she's got one of the classic Raymond Orta shirts.
I was just going to show. I found this looking through all my t-shirts and I said, I need to find it, and I found it. Let me get it real quick.
You're supposed to say you took it off the frame from the wall in the living room, babe.
Oh, I did. Hold on, let me show real quick.
The caution, flying chancla.
That's
a classic
That's a classic.
Raymond, I remember getting this like years ago, Raymond, so thank you. I still have it.
Vintage. Yeah.
Very vintage.
Milagro que ya no está una thrift store.
Oye, se ve nuevecita la t-shirt, carnal.
Lo que iba a decir, usa suavitel.
The screen printers at the Edinburgh.
They found your old school DVD in a thrift store once.
Yeah,
right?
I've seen some of my t-shirts in a thrift store. Yeah, when your t-shirt makes it through a thrift store,
you made it.
Cuando estás en el Goodwill, no me cállate la boca, shut up. O si están haciendo piratería en la pulga de tu merchandise, cállate la boca, shut up.
I've been there, bro. I've been there. Yes.
Con las candles o qué?
Well, the candles and my CDs were getting bootlegged. Y dije, oh, they're selling my CDs. Bootlegged
DVDs, los DVDs.
En la pulga de Álamo.
Cebolla.
Ya la hice, carnal. Ya la hice.
The Mercadome is the dream.
That's like intocable level.
That's a pulga de Álamo, the Mercadome.
Mercadome. I'm already at the Square Garden for
the level of Los Cadetes de Linares at this point.
La boca shut up, bro.
La madre.
Nobody distributes CDs. Not even Sony distributes CDs faster than La Pulga's. Let me tell you, bro.
That's right. That's right.
And we've got Chaz over here. What's up, Chaz? How you doing, bro?
That's right. Charlie Corona here. Retired professional DJ I was on Que Pasa 99.5. Did you know that, Rock? I did overnights on Que Pasa.
I had no idea.
I did KVOY. And of course, I did Q94.5, where I was the Duke of Debauchery and the He-Man of Hedonism. And now here on the third year of the Rock and Chaz Show.
And he's also a full-time aphrodisiac.
That is true. And and psychologist at a local college. I won't say.
The late night at Que Pasa, bro. The late night. So, todos los cocos.
Yeah.
Todos los cocos.
Big time.
Beto Quintanilla, carnal.
Just press my da-da-da-da-da. Ta-da.
And ladies and gentlemen, we have Trangos Amaro was requested for the 20th time this hour. All right, and we've got Raymond Orta, man. What's going on, Raymond? How you doing, man?
Comedian extraordinaire, number one in the game, so get used to the name. I love to do what I do. And I love to give praises to the Most High, King of Kings, more than anything else. And anybody that's watching, if I can tell you one thing, repent and believe the gospel.
There you go. Yeah. Woo!
Amen, bro.
We have just been ordained today.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Hey, Raymond, by the way, congratulations. You want to tell everybody about July the 8th? Just
hot off the press? Hot off the press, man. We're going to be, Mario and myself are going to be in Laredo at this brand new venue. Se llama El Castilian Royal, ¿verdad?
Castilian Royal.
No es el Reptilian Royal.
That's at Epstein Island. that's at Epstein Island, folks. Oh, my God. That venue is specifically at St. James Island next to Epstein Motel.
Vamos a estar en el Reptilian Royal. Y eso, todos los bichos políticos ahí.
Ahorita sale Alex Jones. Let me tell you something, folks.
About these reptilians.
The Reptilian are trying to get to you through comedy. They're trying to put fluoride in the water and turning the frogs gay.
The shrimp are committing suicide.
Turning the frogs
gay. Dude, I can't believe they canceled that dude. He's a comedian, dude. He's funny, but he's also very smart.
Hey, have you heard that there's a conspiracy theory that Alex Jones is in reality Bill Hicks?
Mm-hmm.
That he faked his death?
I've heard of that. And, you know, nothing better than having a conspiracy theory of that nature for a guy that's considered a conspiracy theorist. But the thing is everything is a conspiracy theory until it turns true. You know what I mean?
Everything's a conspiracy theory for about 6 months until it becomes fact.
And then it becomes fact. And they never say we called it a conspiracy theory. Right. They'll never say that, right?
Russian collusion.
Yeah. So, but it's interesting how the guy, he was one of the first guys to ever get deplatformed from everything.
Banned even from PayPal.
Mm-hmm.
Que le quiten el PayPal. Like, wow.
And then after that, everybody was game. They started banning people. They started censoring people. They started keeping
mi fan page, bro.
See, what happened to you, Mario?
Those fight commentary videos, me said, don't delete me fan page, bro.
On Facebook?
92,000 followers, bro. Yeah. On Facebook, yeah.
Speaking of those videos, I love watching those videos. What Mario does, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't know.
Tell him, Rock.
He does videos of fights. Like, you know how people start fighting and everybody pulls, instead of going in and breaking it up, they pull out their phones to record
it. Can I say something? I've never done one when a guy hits a lady. I don't like doing those, bro.
No, you can't do that.
The one that happened this past
weekend. At Alton Glory in Brownsville?
Yes, bro. Me dio chingos de coraje que el vato ahí gritando world star and the lady's getting kicked in the face.
Damn.
That's pretty crazy.
Bro. I haven't seen that one.
Did you do commentary on that one?
No, I don't like doing commentary when it's a guy.
Well, I mean, I wonder if the guy got arrested. I mean,
was a rumor that the lady had passed away.
Yeah,
for real.
It was a couple fighting. There was two ladies fighting and then two dudes. So the dude's beating up a guy and the chick's beating up the chick.
It was a mixed tag.
Sí, se le escapa el vato and he sees that his chick's getting beat up, so he kicks the lady in the face, bro. She gets knocked out, so the guy le da más chingo de coraje and starts beating up the guy, y luego que se mete su camarada. Yeah. So now in Montaneros, but also hitting ladies, bro. Like, nombre.
It's crazy when I see videos like that. You usually do like women on women or men on men. Yeah. We have a sample of it, ladies and gentlemen. But we're going to tell you right now, Mario doesn't hold back with the language. He's going to use the words that are pretty funny, so let's check out one of them, and we'll be right back, all right? Here we go.
What in the... What's so pinche Mario? She flew in like she's applying for Section 8 way, Chichero! These Herbalife meetings get wild, bro! The powder pasta girls, you know? Chingos de National Geographic, Chichero! Esas pinches chiches! Quítate toda la verga! That dude in the red shirt, get out of the way! Oye, that chicken yellow, she has some nice cake, bro. Chingos de squats picking up all her kids' toys with 8 of them. Y ahí sigue el pinche chichero de National Geographic, güey. Pues su pinche madre, the powder passing girls. Y esa ruca de purple, güey. Esa ruca corre tanque en SATF, güey. Hey, she shouldn't be out pregnant, güey. No mames.
Bro.
Oh my God.
Bro, where the hell was that video?
Downtown.
Downtown McAllen.
Sí, downtown.
No mirate la vieja embarazada.
Only here. Downtown.
Así se portan en downtown McAllen, bro.
Es lo que había.
Así se portan bien, Rock.
We have another one, man. Let's check out the other one.
Hold on.
All right. Yeah, this guy, you got to follow him on YouTube and on social media.
Okay. I've seen this one. It's shitty, bro. Mira, ¿qué onda con el Bob Bundy, güey? Ahora, vergazos, güey, se te cayó la cap. Se le ve toda la cola al Bob Bundy, güey. Deja tú, güey, tiene designer jeans el vato, güey. Güey, tápate, Bob Bundy. Y se te mira todo el seso, güey. Y, güey, oh, pinche pelo, güey. Córtate el pelo, Bob Bundy, ya. Yeah. Break it up. Break that shit up. Break that shit up, man. Yeah, cálmense. Yeah. Dense un beso, man. Yeah. Tanta caca, güey. Ya, yeah, pues. ¡Ah! ¡Ay, güey! ¡Ey! ¡Se te salió caca! Y sigue peleando el güey, dude. You gotta get. Le vas a dar la. ¡Oh! ¡Chingao! ¡Límpiate, güey! Toda la pinche caca, güey. ¡Oh! Y sigue peleando, güey. I would have immediately stopped the fight. Mira, ¡oh!
¡Oh, my God! Ya se dio la caca.
Y se talla el pelo, güey.
¡Oh! Se entera el tiempo, bro. Oye, bro, desgraciada, Bob Bundy.
¡Oh, my God!
I actually messaged Bob Bundy, man, if he wanted to be on the show. Nunca me contestó el vato en el Instagram, carnal. I wanted to bring him in, man. I wanted to check him out.
¿Es el Valle, Bob Bundy?
No, he's from Houston. Houston. He's a rapper. Check him out. He's a lot of fun to watch.
He's funny, man. He's funny.
Tiene un video cuando está en el beach con una ruca. Se watchan bien raza, you know what I mean? But it's awesome, man. I wanted to bring him into the show. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's what Mario does, and he does it well, man.
That's what Mario does, baby.
Yeah. So you have a YouTube channel, right, Mario, that you do this on?
Yeah, I've been putting them more on Twitter now. Dude, I'm on probation everywhere. I'm not on probation in real life anymore, but I'm on probation on Instagram, on TikTok, and on YouTube. Bro. I can't get monetized anywhere, bro.
Did you, why are you on probation on YouTube?
Por los videos. But I did one that was... A lady beating up some dude.
Okay.
And they flagged that one. I don't know because it was, I guess, domestic violence, I guess it was. But because YouTube hardly.
When it's women on men, it probably, yeah. Right? Or men on women. Yeah, that's just domestic shit.
Pero ahorita, Elon Musk, I'm going to start putting all my fight videos on Twitter nomás.
Yeah.
It's the only place that they won't ban me.
I thought YouTube, maybe in YouTube, because you have to, like, you can make it not for children.
See,
you know, you know, 18 and over, whatever. And I think you can be a little bit more, you know, a little bit different down there, a little bit more pushing the envelope type. Are any of these videos, did they ever take you down on YouTube for any of these videos?
Yeah, that's why I'm on probation now. I did one back in March.
But the videos we just showed.
Those didn't give you any problems? Those are good. Yeah, right. So you're good.
So as long as there's caca and nudity, you're fine.
National Geographic cheating.
There was no.
But as long as there's a man defecating, it's totally cool.
But there was no. I mean, you were saying Chichero, it was like the bras, right? There were bras. I didn't see any nudity or anything like that.
No, there was a Chichero hanging out.
Yeah, there was a boob.
I don't know. No, they didn't zoom into the nipple, bro. It could be flopping as much as it can. By the way, I love that word.
El pezón.
Oh my God.
The Tongan sand dollar.
Well, I found
the island of Tonga.
I found a video for you, man, but I don't know where we should put it. Should we put it? What do you think? It shows like a chick in a thong, right? She's got a thong on, you know.
Look at all those music videos. It's like chicks and thongs anyways. I mean,
look at that. What's the name of that?
Look at Vince McMahon.
That lady rapper. That lady rapper.
Nicki Minaj?
Yeah, Nicki Minaj. Yeah, she shows up in her thong. Yeah, so go ahead and put it.
Shows up in her WAP.
So you can see it. This is what I'm going to offer.
WAP.
Mario. I'm going to offer Mario this, you know, just for
showing
up.
Are we talking
up
over this
show.
Video?
Yeah, we could talk.
Let Mario do it. Yeah. Let Mario do it.
Okay, Mario, go for it.
Orale. Mario's going to do this real time, ladies
this
and gentlemen.
This is live and real time.
Yeah, we're putting a video up, and he's going to talk over it. Okay?
First up.
What in the dollar buffet strip club is going up in here, bro? Esas son todas las B-team strippers, carnal. Yeah. Line back and fighting right there, way. She looks like a trash bag.
Hey, that guy walked out like that guy that came out on a Show Me the Money. What was his name? The black dude that came out on that movie, man.
Cuba Gooding.
Cuba Gooding. You walked out like Cuba Gooding, dude, out there, man.
I felt like you didn't get the very beginning where she was doing the waffle stuff.
Yeah, you got it.
The waffle stuff. Right, wait a minute. It kind of was missing.
Donde tenía todas las nalgas de fuera.
Because her nalgas were like gyrating and to this
gyrating.
Song.
Gyrating. I like that word. To
So, ladies and gentlemen, those videos are brought to you by Joe's Master Service Center.
All right, Joe.
Damn, dog.
Thank you, Joe.
Damn, dog.
He's proud of that.
Probably serving the local Edinburgh, Texas area for over 50 years. Joe understands getting your car fixed and having that air conditioning working on this type of summer here in South Texas is very, very important, and he can help you out. He can put some of that Freon in your vehicle. He can check the tires because the gas prices aren't getting any lower. You need your car to be working in tip-top shape in order for it to be able to save you gas. So you take it to Joe. Tell him, Joe, I want you to make this car gas efficient. I want you to check everything on it, change the oil, check the tires, make sure the air is perfect. Put some of that AC Freon on there because if it has low Freon, it works harder and it spends more gas. You need to take it to Joe's Master Service. Man, this guy will check out your vehicle and it'll make it a whole lot better for you in this hot summer time here in the South Texas area. There's his dad. Yep. His dad is still working there. And you know, sometimes after you go to Joe's and he takes care of your vehicle, you're going to want to go just to hang out on the chair there outside. Yeah. Just hang out. Yeah, it's a good place to loiter.
Some smoke.
It's a good place to loiter. Joe's Master Service. Thank you so much, Joe.
And and you can't, I saw that you can put your breathalyzer on there too, bro. I recognize that sign right away.
You can do that.
Shout out.
He does that. Joe can do that. And he can also do your inspection. You need a U-Haul whenever you guys go touring and you need to take some clothes and stuff like that. Props. The U-Haul's right there.
Props.
You go talk. Yeah, bro. You know, if you need that. All right. So now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go to Jax Phoenix. And he's got comments, shout outs, and the awkward questions.
Ooh, there's some on the chat.
Brought to you by the Greenhead, offering a natural alternative for stress and pain with various CBD infused oils, lotions, and also some goodies and
Shout out to the Greenhead, man. I know the owners, man. They're good people, bro.
Yeah, man. Louie and Javi and Hector, man, those guys are super cool and they know what their products are. They know everything about them. They've even tried them before they sell them to you. They got
quality control.
They got amazing name brand bongs as well. Like, check out this bong right here, man. It's a Chich Marin bong.
Oh, wow. So I thought you guys put that out for us.
A little gift basket. Yeah, we'd give it to you guys, but we like it here as a piece of furniture. You know what
it's
I mean?
Good.
They've got detoxes as well to help purge all the toxins your body absorbs, full body and mental relaxation. Veterans are always welcome at the Greenhead, man. They always get good deals there. And of course, Hector, Louie, and Javi. Do these guys know everything about what they have, bro? These guys are smart. We had them on the show. Look them up. Hashtag PBT, hashtag Greenhead. You'll see the show. The guys were hilarious, and they've got some real great knowledge on all the stuff they sell. FAR Texas, 956-666-9088. And then in Mission, it's 956-591-0114. The Green Hit is the perfect place for relaxing the mind and spirit in an all-natural way. Follow them on Instagram and Facebook, okay? All right. So Jax Phoenix, let's do it.
Shout out to Fresno, California, Thomas Rodriguez. Shout out to Jose Z1 in Lubbock, Texas. Shout out to Sergio Gonzalez in Kennedy, Texas. Laura from Ohio, shout out.
All right.
And we do have some awkward questions for our guests.
All right, we're
here
ready.
Here we go.
All right, so the first question comes from Michael Pena in Laredo, Texas, and he says, have any of you guys ever had anal leakage?
Oh, shit. Holy smoke. I think Mario probably, right?
I want to know. Why Mario?
I don't even eat potato chips.
La dieta de Mario, no.
That leads us to our next sponsor.
I think they asked that question because of the guy que se cagó ahorita.
They got fecal matter on their mind.
So have you guys had any anal leakage or anything?
I'll say this when I was not taking care of my diet, and I was
I know what he's gonna do. Y me lo quitó la moringa.
I used to have anal leakage, but then I drank moringa. And now the anal leakage is no more. Thanks, moringa.
Right now, somebody's watching. Oye, viejo, ya te puedes quitar el toilet paper entre medio las nalgas?
Yeah, like a magician.
Dicen, does the moringa also cure blood leakage?
Yeah. Oh my God.
No, ya me está cabrón, bro. Pinches almorranas.
Te hace seal todo el pedo. No, pero anybody that is suffering from anal leakage, wey, it's due to gut health, wey.
Yeah,
it is. Te la bañaste, wey. Con el toilet paper, vato. Y lo pinche Charlie con el magician, wey. Sigue saliendo el toilet paper.
Yeah. And it's the wife telling him, right? Ya me cansé de limpiar tus calzoncillos mojados y la chica.
Pinches calzones en rusted de amare.
Deja tú el vato que tiene anal leakage, tiene Sancha y todo el pollo y la vieja. Ni te sabes limpiar la cola.
¿Sabes qué, vieja? Voy a agarrar unos boxer shorts con brown polka dots para que no sepas a cuál es la spot.
Leopard print, puro plaid.
Yo por eso nomás los compro de colores, dad.
Oye, bro, remember that story I told you, bro, cuando estaban los Marines? I was in the Marine Corps.
Oh my God, okay.
And you had anal leakage or what?
It was worse than anal leakage.
It wasn't just a leak.
Yeah, bro. So
Niagara Falls.
So my home, era Marine también de Bronzeville. Shout out to Peña, bro, camarada. And
it's the first time he pulls out, people.
Fidgeting.
And I'm done.
So these dudes, okay. they hook the me and this other homeboy, my Melgar, those three of us. Well, they hook up with these two beautiful ladies, bro. And I'm not gonna say I was a third wheel at that time, but I was. I didn't get fifth wheel. I didn't hook up with anybody, and so you know what I did instead. I was in the Marine Corps at the time. Instead, I ate chingos of tacos, bro. Con marranier, bro. Mm-hmm. And these guys went. I was wearing leather pants at the time. Maybe that's why I didn't score, bro. I was wearing leather pants.
Jim Morrison,
I thought I looked good.
I wizard, yeah.
And we crossed over back to San Diego, bro. They go do their thing with their ladies. Y pues yo me quedo ahí solo in a couch. Mm-hmm. I wake up like at 7 in the morning. They're still passed out. I had to go, you know, nature
Popo.
Calls.
Te andabas cagando.
Then I felt it was going to be such a
un pinche blowout bruto.
Va a estar chingón la caca.
Oh my God.
Como decía,
tres sincronizadas. Iba
a parecer un crocodile entrando el swamp water, carnal.
Right.
Como decía Raymond, #CMC, casi me cago.
I didn't want to be rude, bro. So I was like, you know what? I'm not gonna take a dump here in this house. It's a beautiful house, bro. I don't want to cock block my friends, bro. Let me go look for a restroom. Let me go look for a restroom there. So I grabbed my friend's keys to go to the car. Ooh. And then there at the car, I grabbed the wrong keys. I couldn't get in the car. So I was just walking around. I couldn't make it back to the house. And then I thought to myself, se me hace que la caca va a salir solid.
Wait, hold on a second. Por qué dijiste, what made you think that?
I was just trying to, I guess, manifest it. I was trying to tell myself right. It's going to come out.
You were
going to be one of those hard protein, one of those
hard protein.
Pinche ladrillo. You wipe, no se mira nada en el toilet.
How many Keurigs did it measure? How many Keurigs?
Entonces, ¿qué pasó, Mario?
No, so dije, no, pues déjame cagarme aquí, and I'll move the pant sleeve. Así, and it'll slide right down because it's going to be.
Oh, shit.
That's what I went through my head. I was still kind of inebriated, bro.
He's pulling the whole Houdini.
Que me sale, y pues, dude, no, it didn't come out hard at all, and I'm wearing leather pants. I'm wearing leather pants. And
Wow.
Like, ya la cagué.
Ya la cagué. Literally. We got a couple more awkward questions for our guests here.
Let's do it.
All right, we have another one here. It's from Joe999 from Fresno, California. He says,
"Ooh, Fresno.
Fresno, California. They're watching from all the way over there. Shout out to Fresno." He says, "Have y'all ever sprayed cologne on your scrotum?"
Oh my god.
Not cologne, but baby wipe.
baby wipe. Yeah. The trick is, it's not to spray cologne on the scrotum in case you have somebody go down there and give you some lickage.
Lickage. Right?
But to put cologne on the pubic area so that they don't eat cologne while you're teabagging them, I guess. I'm trying to figure out a way to say this politely.
You're trying to say like hairspray?
No, like cologne on the scrot.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
But so, like, no, just put it in the pubic area. I've done that before.
Oh, yeah, in the pubic area. Yeah, in el afro.
So you've never...
In el afro. In el bush fro.
So you guys have never sprayed any cologne in your testicles or your...
Not the scrot.
Okay, yeah. I have, and let me tell you, se pone calientito.
See? I don't know why.
Right there.
Like it pica.
I don't even like to put my phone in my pocket.
And you know what it is? It's all the alcohol evaporating. Oye, that's what it is.
Oye, viejo, tus huevos huelen a Stetson. Right.
Huele Bruto.
Esas bolas huelen a cool water.
Oye, agüítate cuando huele a quorum. ¿Te acuerdas de ese? Puro pinche raid about that.
Oye, viejo. No, like Old Spice, like a ketchup bottle.
Oye, viejo, tu culo huele a puro obsession.
Oye, luego el culito bien bleach, bien pinte a madre.
It's chrome.
Are there any more? Do we have any more questions?
Yeah, we have. Oh, yeah, it's getting awkward. This is what Super we wanted, awkward. Guys. Yeah, that's yeah. what we got. This is what we want for the fans, because you guys, we're giving you what you want, all right?
It's for the people.
It's for the fans.
Give the people what they want.
A poop story.
People power.
We keep them entertained. We have another question here. We're actually, it's from Fish Felicia.
Oh.
Hi, Fish.
Oh, that lit.
And she says, "Mario, what size of underwear do you wear?"
2XL.
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 And
those, like the hip hop magazine.
And the models in those 2XL, that's not a 2XL model.
No mamadas,
porque tienes abs, carnal. You wear a 2XL.
Right.
Oye, como los wrestlers que están bien mamados y tienen los cuadritos, pero tienen pancita. Like, how does that even happen?
Like Chris Jericho. He was having a stomach.
Yeah.
But he you could see his abs. I'm like, that defies anatomy.
Yeah. How the hell does that happen?
That's
literally a
great Tonko right there, right behind you.
Y de ahí tiene un peca.
Oh yeah, that's true.
All the wrestlers have like this
separation.
Como Kofi Kingston.
Como metido, right?
Sí. Yeah. I heard it's because of all the chops.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
Oh, okay.
Their pecs are now delts.
I've seen Raymond Horta without a shirt, and he has that too. Tiene los cuadritos así, Raymond Horta, allá en la beach. Cuando fui para la beach, ¿te acuerdas, bro? Pinches cuadritos. You've never seen Raymond Horta without a shirt, guys. That's you're never going to see him. But he has cuadritos. I've seen him.
Big pecs equal big paychecks.
We have another question here, guys. We have another question.
We got one more. Let's do it.
Got to get that copyrighted.
We got another one here. From Ernesto Rodriguez, Texas City, Texas. He says, "Do you guys take pictures of your poop and text them to your friends?"
I know these guys used to do that.
Yeah, that's actually funny. Oh, that's fucking funny.
I'm going to be truthful with you. Rock and I have a very close relationship. Rock and Roll James and I are fans of each other's gut health.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Yeah.
And I'll be even more. I'll take this to a step up in the awkward conversation. Rock not only has sent me pictures of his poop, but he sent me pictures of his wife's poop.
Oh!
Yeah. Yeah. Let me tell you this. Riley can drop a log. Oh, yeah. Riley takes fiber.
Oh,
she takes fiber.
God.
Probiotics.
She takes fiber.
Riley takes fiber. Riley takes fiber. Riley takes fiber.
Oye, puro Metamucil.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I'm sweating here.
Oh my God, I've never seen producer Riley that red.
Oh my God.
That's why when I first saw that, I said, "This is the woman of my life."
Hey,
This is the woman.
Ponle el anillo, carnal. Right. Ponle el anillo.
Yeah, this is not like Mario Salazar stuff. No, this is granite. Mount Rushmore.
Oye, carnal. Oye, carnal. ¿Quieren ver anillo? Pon el camera, baby. Ponle la camera. Enséñale el pinche anillo que te tengo.
Let's look at this ring.
Ponle la piedrota.
Enséñale la piedrota. Mira nomás.
Wow. Esas son varios anillos.
Dice Mario, enseña la piedrota. Not the poop.
Dad, I think the next question is the worst one.
Oh, no.
Se guachaba como una moray eel sticking out of the hole from the bottom of the toilet.
There used to be that ratemypoop.com.
Yeah, ratemypoop.com. Yeah.
What? That's a thing?
Mm-hmm. You're on the home page.
Por eso les pregunto. That's why I'm asking you guys.
You're on the home page.
That's why I asked you guys, how many Keurigs is it? Because
Riley's the screensaver.
Yeah.
She's on the logo.
She's the cover photo.
Yeah. The banner. She's
fan
the top
of the
banner.
Week. Fan of the week.
She's the love of my life. All right, let's do the next question. What do you guys think about this awkward question stuff?
There are some really awkward ones. I'm like, oh my God.
Okay. How about it?
Oh my God. This is my favorite. Before we go into it, I'm just going to share something that my poops are crazy. I call them islands because when I poop, it comes out of the agüita. So I call them my little islands. Yeah,
it's a volcano.
You
yeah.
call them volcanoes. I call them islands.
Wow, dude.
Parecen lily pads and el pinche swamp.
I'm going to say, now that you guys are fans of that, I'm going to send you some. So, okay, we got another one. It's Rico A. Suave.
Oye, cálmate.
Rico.
From Tampa, Florida says, have any of you suffered from smelly penis?
Ew.
Smelly penis?
No way.
And so for those of you that don't speak English, people, si le duele el pito.
Like when you're taking a piss in the urinal and you can smell your...
my God.
I don't know. Mario, have you ever had that?
Smelly pito.
Smelly pito.
That sounds like El Chavo's friend. El Chavo's friend, smelly pito.
Hey, you guys are on the road. Y no se bañan por tres días. No se bañan por tres días. Y se paran en un strike.
I had bubble guts, and some chick wanted to go down on me.
Oh my gosh.
I don't know if that's a good idea.
No,
hey, and y te estabas pidiendo, and all the farts were just coming up from the front.
Entre los huevitos.
In between your
huevitos.
And up the scrot. And then she wants to go down on you, bro.
Entre los huevitos bien calientes.
The next time I went over, I went to her house, and she's like, hey, you can relax. You want anything to eat? You want to take a shower?
Corto.
She had never asked me that before. I was like,
nah. No, yeah,
you want to rinse your dick?
I have some fabuloso.
You could use my sink.
Oye, Dad.
Sink?
Take off your leather pants.
Pinche burnt bath, güey, así.
Cuando tiene quesito.
Yeah. Cuando tiene quesito. Oh, that's the best, bro. I have a joke about that.
A smegma surprise.
Quítale el dick cheese. Pinche pinga reminds me of cheese.
Oh my God.
I can never go to CC's again, asshole.
Because of your blubber.
Puro pinche parmesan.
Sí, la parmesan.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Jax Phoenix in our chat zone awkward question.
This is Jax Phoenix and the smelly pitos.
Forever I will be associated with smelly pitos now. Why, man? Why are you doing this to me?
That sounds like a great name for a band, though.
It does,
the smelly pitos.
The smelly pitos. The smelly pitos.
The stinky horns.
Oh, my God. You guys are crazy. I love this shit.
All right, man. I hope you all enjoyed that, ladies and gentlemen. And once again,
pat yourself on the back.
And all our fans on the chat zone, we appreciate you. Make sure to like, subscribe, and share. Okay? And that way we can get more fans and more people can find out about what we do. And we do this live Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday nights, three nights out of the week. If you want to be part of the show, if you want your business or your product to be part of Tuesday or Thursday, because Wednesday, we're totally packed already.
Sorry.
All right. We've already got too many sponsors on Wednesday. And that's why we opened up Thursday and Friday, because we've had people wanting to be
Tuesday
part of it.
Tuesday and Thursday.
I mean, Tuesday and Thursday. What did I say? Thursday and
Thursday
Friday?
Thursday and
Friday. Yeah, Tuesday and Thursday. I'm trying to keep up here. 956-641-3241 Texas, and we'll do what we can for you too. We can get some business. We'll put your Instagram and your website stuff on the description, and people can go to your business.
If you want your business to be associated with Smelly Pitos, this is the channel. Yeah,
this is the place
right here.
Leather poop pants.
If you watch the show, ladies and gentlemen, we have a whole bunch of different type of artists and guests, and sometimes it gets a little crazy and sometimes a little serious. So, all right. Yeah. So we're doing some headlines now, ladies and gentlemen, and one of the major headlines today, we want to congratulate a young girl by the name of Myra Flores.
Yeah.
She's making headlines. She put up the headline there. Republican Myra Flores flips Texas House District red in a special election. Now, she is the first Mexican-born congresswoman to serve in the House. How cool is that?
Nice. That's awesome.
That's quite progressive.
Mexican-born, and then she is also the first Republican to ever hold that seat.
That
ever
district.
In the history of that district. So, congratulations to her, man. And, I mean, it's pretty interesting how everything is going on right now in the political world, with elections and all that. Now, she's going to hold that seat till November, and then I think she's running against...
Vicente González.
Is that who she's running against? It'll be in November. So, we'll see what happens after that. But congratulations to her. Who knows? She might not be able to push it past November, or she might. I don't know. What do you guys think?
I think everybody in the Valley should get behind her in a big way, because it's a Mexican-born woman really doing something for the Valley in a way that is in a position that has predominantly been dominated by men.
And she is also married to a border patrolman. Yeah. So the border patrolman, I actually asked if, they wanted to come in, because I was interested, because I'll see everywhere I was seeing her advertisement. She had a very good branding campaign. She was on, you hit a YouTube video, boom, she'd pop up. You'd watch the news, she'd pop up like three or four times.
I wanted to hang out with her dad. Dude.
And her commercials were really cool. I mean, they were really, really well done. So she had some really great work done for her branding. And I asked, hey, why don't you come in?
Yeah.
So I want to get to know you all. And
what did she say?
And bring your husband. And she said, my husband can't be on. Because there's,
conflict of interest with the federal agents.
The border patrolman can't speak to any type of media or anything because of the administration that's on, and they've got this gag order on them.
Wow.
So they can't. Yeah. So there's no transparency there. I mean, we don't know what's going on in the border patrolmen that are on the front lines. They can't tell us, and they can't talk to the media to inform us what's really going on at the border. And so I was like, dang, God, because I wanted to have her and her husband here. You know what I mean? So we could talk. But I asked her, man, we'll probably bring her in so we can find out more about her. But congratulations to her. She is Mexican born, and she is in the House now, and the U.S. House special election winner, Myra Flores, here in Texas, and pretty interesting.
She's making national news, bro, all over the place.
She made history twice. She's first Mexican born, and she is the first Republican and female. So that's three.
There
in that district.
That's what we call a hat trick.
Wow, man, congratulations.
Trifecta.
All right, what's the next headline we got over here? Let's see.
Vince McMahon.
While your preferred tampons may be difficult to find, plus how to get around the shortage. So there's a tampon shortage, ladies and gentlemen.
Revelations, bro.
Speaking of anal leakage earlier.
Anal leakage.
I think they have man ponds for that, right?
Man ponds.
They were saying that on the chat. Yeah, the man pods.
Yeah. So we've had, what do you call a baby formula shortage?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So now we have a tampon shortage. Have you seen any of that, babe? Have you gone?
I have. We were at CVS, or I was at CVS with my mom, and then we also went grocery shopping to HEB, and a lot of the stuff was gone.
Female products?
Yes. A lot of the tampons and stuff like that. There was a very, very limited amount.
Well, so what happens is when an article like that comes out, people go and they buy them all.
Yeah. Exactly. And then, I think that's what happens.
And then they make it worse.
And they put it in a rider truck and they park in the corner about a block away from La Pulga de Alamo and they sell them.
Yeah.
Tenemos tampones.
Como el toilet paper, carnal. ¿Te acuerdas el toilet paper? No hayas toilet paper, carnal.
Quería hacer algo yo y... I wanted to do something when there was like the baby formula shortage y ponerme allí en un lado de La Pulga a ponerme a vender baby formula like containers. Pero nomás los containers, güey.
No, nothing in them.
Yeah. Los puros containers nomás and have people come over like and hike up the price a 100 bolas cada uno, güey. And have people come up to me and yelling at me, ¿por qué le vas a hacer a la gente? Why are you going to do that to the people that are struggling? Pues compra uno. And then when they buy one and they see it's empty, way it's like, oh, it's just a container.
Yeah.
I'm not selling baby for no refunds. Hey, no refunds. No
refunds. I heard that the cartels were willing to give us like I don't know how many tons of baby formula that's there in cans and.
Wow. Ahora están cortando el pedo con pase. They're cutting the baby formula con cocaine.
We want to thank the cartel for sending us baby formula.
Cartel del Golfo.
Oye, los babies todos prendidos, ¿no?
Como Mars Attacks.
Hey, Raymond, why do you think that happens, though? Why do you think there's so much shortage, bro?
It's all by design, bro. It's all by design. Whether you want to believe the right-wing story or the left-wing story, the left-wing story is they're hell-bent on destroying America and ushering the new world order. That's what's going on. The Democrats are trying to usher in a one-world government where the government and the bankers are in charge, and they're the ones that hold all the power, and you depend on them and them alone in order for you to live. And if you don't depend on them, you're not going to live a very good, happy life.
What do you got to say about that, Mario?
I've been hearing not only shortages y todo, but they've been burning down all sorts of farms, bro.
The egg food processing plants.
Is that true, bro? Oh,
yeah. Dude, there was I got a video today.
Bro, ahorita las noticias, si se quema un cuartito en un pinche factory, van a decir que se está quemando la factory, carnal. I don't know, man. It's hard to trust the news nowadays.
No, but no, that's the thing. It's not on the news. It's like, it's people on like on Twitter and
sí, pues todos quieren share and likes y la chingada también, güey.
There's a, I got a video today of a farmer in Nebraska or one of those states that breeds cows.
Kansas?
It might have been Kansas where there was 3,000 or so dead cattle for no reason from one day to the next. They're just dead, drop dead.
Damn, bro.
I don't know about that.
John Dutton, bro.
I mean, but. What they were saying is the reason there's so many shortages is because during COVID, they were pumping out money to everybody, right? They were printing money and pumping that stimulus, all that shit. And then they were giving businesses a chingos of feria. What was the name? The PPP loans? Yeah, the PPP loans. So some businesses were getting $100,000, $300,000, $50,000, whatever. Mm-hmm. Even bands were capable of getting that money as well. And so they were getting the money and they were buying everything and everything was closed down and shut down and nobody was producing anything. So they bought everything up. And now that they were not out of the lockdowns, they're still trying to catch up. And now everybody's free. So everybody's buying. And it's like the demand is like overtaking the...
They're one step behind.
Yeah. And so, I was thinking, well, we probably need a whole other lockdown for people to stop buying so everything can catch up. And I don't know how when it's going to catch up, bro. So now they're raising the gas up to $5. So we buy less gas. Maybe they'll catch up to it. You know what I mean?
There was a time that you and I were talking about that if they continued voting in this fashion, that gas prices would go up to $8 to $9. I remember estimating myself $8 to $9 a gallon of gas.
Mm-hmm.
And I was thinking I was exaggerating.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But even now, they're preparing the computers and the digital displays at the gas pump to incorporate an extra digit so they can incorporate $10 for a gallon of gas. Yeah. So they can add an extra digit to make it to fully display the price.
Yeah. How are you guys going to do it? I mean, the thing about this is the gas and the prices and the inflation, because diesel is $5.50 right now. Trailers need to put diesel. It's going to cost them so much money. Some of them are going to get out of business, and some of them are going to still work, and they're going to have to add those prices to the product that they're carrying, and the product goes into the HEBs and into the supermarkets, and then the product's going to be a high price. It's just going to keep rolling that way. I don't know how it's going to affect, you know, concerts, comedy shows. You buy tickets for a concert, man, you're looking at spending at least almost $500 for a couple of tickets sometimes. Yeah. You know, who can afford that now when you got to put gas? There's people with vehicles that spend a lot of gas and get low mileage. You know what I mean? There's some. I'm in a Versa right now, man. I'm in a what is it? A
2009.
Yeah. What is it? Nissan Versa. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Little car.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And
little putt.
$20 me casi un tanque lleno.
I just posted today, man. That was like, I'm so grateful for every merch and every ticket I sell because everything's so expensive nowadays. Yo tuve que subir mis t-shirt prices of 25.
Arrímate el micrófono cuando hablas de $25.
Sí,
tú and that's still cheap, bro.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I went to a concert this Sunday, Hombres G. Their t-shirts were $45. Oh, it was 40, pero me cobraron la fat tax.
No,
XL fat tax.
Yeah, y pero sabes que en los venues esos tienen que cobrar más por la t-shirt porque el venue le está cobrando al grupo.
True, yes. Oh, yeah.
Yes. I remember que pasó el cáncer de tu papá, bro. That was so gangster of him. We did the Laredo Energy Arena.
There was this guy that got in my dad's face, bro, trying to collect the fee from my dad.
Uh-huh.
Trying to tax my dad, bro. Yeah. My dad, nombre, güey. My dad era bandido y a madre.
Chinga tu madre,
carnal. Sí, así, güey. sir, it's going to cost you $1,500 for you to set up a merchandise stand here. And he goes, what do you mean? Oh, it's going to cost you $1,500 in order for you to sell merch. And my dad, no.
No.
What? What do you mean? No. No. What do you, well, that's what it costs, sir. No, no lo va a pagar. But you can't. See, I'm gonna. It's already set up, sir. Ya lo hice. Well, just give me 500 then. No. No le va a dar nada, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Sir, but you need a pay in order to sell. No, I don't. No. And if you don't let me sell here, I'll just go sign. I'll just go set up in the parking lot and we'll sell them outside. Well, then, sir, if you do that, we're going to call the cops. And my dad says, well, if you call the cops, I'm going to know exactly who did it. And I'm going to come in here and kick your ass. Okay, you can just go ahead and leave your table there, sir. It's fine.
Yeah, dude,
they wanted to charge me $1,500 before I even made any money at all. They wanted to charge me $1,500 mm-hmm. just to sell
well,
shirts.
Well, the thing that freaked me out, and one of my guests from a previous show, Percy Cardona, who has played accordion with the Mavericks and Sting, and he's been all over the place from Big Wells, Texas. Great guy, man. You know, I wanted to go see him, the Mavericks. So I wanted to buy 3 tickets for my dad, my wife, and me. And I asked my wife, go to the, you know, ticket service. And she went to the McKellen Performing Arts Center website and clicked the link for tickets. And, you know, they send you to somebody else, you know.
Yeah, on third party.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, third party. And so by the time, you know, the tickets were $109. I said, órale, compra tres a toda madre. Están unos sheets y la chinga. By the time we, you know, checked out, it was like almost $500, dude. It was like $35 each ticket service fee. Yeah. It was an insurance fee of $12.
$12.
And the insurance was in case it gets, canceled, you get your money back. Wow. You know? And then they have a electronic fee and a delivery fee.
Yeah, a delivery fee, and then a tax.
It was almost $60 in fees just to get the ticket, each ticket. And then I think to myself, if they sell 1,000 tickets, how much is that in fees do they make, man? $60,000, bro.
Puros fees.
De puro pinche fee, bato, that you don't even know if they are necessary.
Is it real? Yeah. Is it made up?
You're just
putting it on there.
See, and so I went on social media and said, man, they're going to fucking destroy the music industry, the concert industry. You know, not everybody.
Performing arts.
And also, the fans that can't afford to go that are real true fans, dude, you know, cabrón, bro. You know what I mean? So, you know, I don't know if people are going to be able to afford that with the rising costs of gas, food, and the light bill's going to go up, folks.
Oh, yeah. It's already gone up 70% in Texas, bro.
The kilowatt, all that shit in summer, you're going to be paying. You better turn some lights off. And then the people that have kids that leave lights on everywhere in La Casa.
Nombre, bro.
Nombre, they're going to have to be on.
O dejan la puerta de la refrigerator abierta.
Sí.
Hijo
o la tienen abierta y nomás están viendo. Nunca agarran nada. You know, es una maña que tienen, ¿me entiendes? Yeah. So, you know, you ladies and gentlemen, you all are going to start having to become a little bit frugal. And start, you know.
And before
Harvard,
hey, no.
Harvard.
And before we got on the air, Raymond, remember Rock was saying, you know, that's gerrymandering.
Gerrymandering.
Hey,
Because
yo no conozco a ese vato. Yo conozco Jerry Martinez.
Jerry Briscoe. So, ladies and gentlemen, go and buy tampons today. All right. Okay, so that was the
moral of the story.
The moral of the story. All right. What's the next headline, baby? Let's check it out. Diarrhea of a madman.
The
anal leakage. I thought we already talked about the anal leakage.
Vile poop attack spree on Upper East Side.
Oh my gosh.
Two women hit. Suspect still on the runs.
Runs.
On the runs.
Puros puns?
Y tienen un picture del vato de like, video cameras caught the suspect.
Yeah. Oh he said the motive was just for shits and giggles. That's why I'm a pro, people.
Ba-dum-bum.
That's why I'm the pro.
All right, let's see the next headline, baby.
Hold on.
All right, man. I like this, man. Mugged by a parrot. I Thieving what? Bird grabs Scotch tourist money, 700 pounds.
700 pound wad.
That sounds like a porno.
Yeah. It's a huge wad, sir.
Oh,
yeah.
The poor guy in the upper picture, bro. He's all knocked out. He all the headlines El Parrot, bro.
Let me see it.
What's the top one say?
Yeah.
Knocked out unconscious in 4 a.m. bra.
Hey,
is that Frank Shamrock?
Like I said, crime exclusive.
You know what the parrot said, dude?
Exclusive.
You know what the parrot said? Polly, want your money.
Hotel Chief.
All right, what's the next one, baby?
Pichichi would have thrown it. The parrot said, put it on my bill. They have beaks. They have beaks, Chief, not bills.
What's the, do we have another one? Yes. One-armed man applauds the kindness of strangers.
What is the professional Valley Talk word for that? Aleteando.
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 Y la palabra del día, aleteando.
Aleteando. Aleteando. By el señor de los pitos. Or what was the name of the... Se huele el pito.
Señor de los pitos, señor pestosos.
Chetty. All
right.
Pito feo,
let's see. Is there one more?
Yes.
Computer virus spreads to humans.
Hey,
did you see the one right off of that, babe? The one of the everybody's gonna want those. Bar glasses help you see straight when you're drunk.
Is that a coupon for that on the bottom? Do you mind if I cut that coupon off?
Yeah. No, but you know what? Computer viruses are very, very interesting. Ladies and gentlemen, your phone can get hacked by NSA, by the CIA. They can get into your phone and you don't even know they're in there.
And getting your car while you're driving.
I'm pretty sure they're in Mario's shit already.
There's also there's ways of them being able to go in there. And then if you have apps, sometimes you put an app in your phone. Yeah. Who reads the terms of service on those apps? Because you have to like hit the little check mark. Right? Do you read? Does everybody read those things? What the hell do they say?
They say that you're selling your soul, bro.
You know? And so they listen to you with the apps. Because like Instagram, Facebook, you want to take a picture, you have to let them open your camera. You want to make a video, you have to let them open your microphone.
Yeah.
And they, you know, you want to post one of your pictures, they have to go into your gallery.
Into your files.
Yeah.
And I don't know if Mario and Raymond have known, or your Jax or anybody, but this week I've gotten so many from, you know, just a random friend on your social media. Hey, can I ask you for a favor?
Yeah,
and they're like, here we go. And I was showing Raymond earlier. I just started asking them for money. Hey, before you ask me, I want to ask you something. Put up, can you give me $200?
And you get tempted to answer because the person asking you, her name's April Showers. You know what I mean? And she's got a bikini and a big cleavage and shit. And, you know,
she's legit.
And she's asking you for help. You
she
know?
Only knows four people, and you're like one of them. You're like,
I'm so lucky.
And Jaime Flores is the other one.
And her friend is gerrymandering.
Yeah.
So, I mean,
friends with gerrymandering.
And then you go to the photo gallery, and there's some dudes from Bangladesh on there.
And the Philippines. Like
you are beautiful. It's like, wow.
Please check your inbox.
I'm so lucky.
We got some good comments here from the guests. Can I just jump in real quick?
Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it, man. We're done with the headlines, bro.
Because it says here about what we're talking. We're kind of like talking about conspiracy theories, right? And they're asking here. Jerry Rodriguez says, Jax, ask Horta if he thinks the electric cars can be controlled by the government.
Oh, that's a good question, bro.
Oh, yeah.
1,000% they can. 1,000% they can. It doesn't have to be electric cars. Any car older than I believe... I think the year was 2007. Any year after that, it's trackable.
Yo tengo una 2004 truck.
Yeah.
That's 2001.
Yo tengo una 95.
You're off the grid, Dad? Off the grid.
Yeah, and that's why, actually, if you take the cars right now that are below that year, they're skyrocketing in value for that reason.
What are
like that, like right now, you can buy an old, like... I put it up as a joke because it's a friend of mine's car, but he bought a Honda, like a $1,500 car during 2020.
Mm-hmm.
And right now that car is worth like $16,000-$17,000.
No. Yeah, because
it does like 50 miles a gallon. Yeah. It's like an old Honda Accord.
Besides that, it's because the used car market is very popular because...
Pre-owned.
Yeah, pre-owned because the new cars, they're very expensive. And you don't know if you're really getting what you're paying for, right? And in the used car, they can't charge you more than what it's worth because you go to the blue book and it tells you what it's worth.
Yeah.
So you know exactly how much that's worth. So there's dealerships wanting to buy your car.
Yeah. Have you?
Because they resell it.
If you've been driving and you look at the dealerships and you see a big majority of them are empty, all of that is because there's a computer chip shortage.
Yep.
And... They can't make cars without those computer chips because those are the computer chips that track you. So there's a back order of those computer chips. And where do those chips come from? China. Mm-hmm. And where do they get the minerals to make those computer chips? Afghanistan. Mm-hmm. And who has control of Afghanistan right now? The Taliban. So right now, China is talking to the Taliban to get the minerals and have full control of those computer chips, and they'll monopolize the world with that.
I was talking the other day. I was just, you know, because I'm always thinking crazy shit, right? And I guess I better put this music.
I have some conspiracy theories for Raymond, real quick.
So. Well, hold on a second. I almost forgot what I was going to say.
Are you talking about the cars?
Yeah, we're talking about the cars
and the computer chips.
The computer chips. What's happening is like when there's a war between countries. One country tries to destroy the infrastructure of the other and the supply chain.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we don't have to go and... Our supply chain comes from other countries.
Yep.
Exactly. So they don't have to attack our supply chain. They just have to cut us off, dude.
Big time. Yeah.
Yep.
You know? Yep. And that's what happens with the United States not being self-sufficient and self, you know, consistent.
Especially considering that I think... 85% of our medications come from China, a country that hates us.
Yeah, except if you're from the valley, you go to Progreso.
A huevo.
Progreso.
And check this out. Check this out. Now, everybody wants you to go solar, right?
Si.
Solar. They'll give you subsidies. Where do you think they make all the solar panels? In China.
Wow.
China's going to get all China. That solar money. All that money that the government gives you for solar, you go and you spend it, and in a lot of those solar panels come from China. Everything's made in China.
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 And China also has, because if we would, ban products from China, which we never would because it's their main suppliers of ours, they also have, factories in other countries. So it's made from China, but it's coming from another country that won't have any tariffs or whatever. So they go out and
Vietnam.
Yeah. And so, ladies and gentlemen, that's a question that we had on the chat. So
we have one more.
Hold on.
We got chat.
Raymond is a master of conspiracy theories, and I saw one that I had never seen before. Now, this one's way out there. I mean, there's lunar landings are fake and all that stuff, but this one said, I saw one, that lottery winners or lottery tickets were made to catch time travelers. Raymond, do you believe that time travel is happening?
Time traveling?
Time travelers.
Yes, and I believe in time travel.
Okay, yes.
I believe in time travel, and I believe that it is real.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if they're doing it to... like,
to catch them.
That's really interesting. I've never heard that one.
I saw that one on TikTok the other day.
But I do believe time travel and time traveling is real, and it's happening right now.
Okay.
I do. There's a whole TikTok dedicated to this? Like to
It was like, you know, bizarre conspiracy theories, and it was like this, that, and then the third one was the lottery was created to catch time travelers.
That's nuts.
I gotta ask Raymond that.
That's the first that I heard about that.
But it makes kind of sense.
Saw something about a house in West Laco that has these alien people.
What? Oh yeah,
by Walmart.
Oh yeah, what? Yeah.
In that corner.
Oh yes, so you're
yes. From
Mexico, yes, la casa. Yeah.
Vienen del otro lado.
They're from Oaxaca, wey.
Son de China, Nuevo León, wey.
Raymond, do you know anything about that house?
Yeah, a cult that's waiting for some aliens to take them away or something.
Yeah,
like
some
that.
Cult. Yeah.
Every time I see that compound, I think of the compound that Dude, Where's Your Car landed in. Those guys, they landed in a compound. Right?
Oh, the Zoltan.
It was sort of like that, dude.
Like one of those, cult back in the day, the ones that drank the Kool-Aid?
Jim Jones?
Yeah.
Is it like that or what?
No, man, it's not religious. It's sci-fi, you know. I think it's
Scientology.
I don't know how true it is. I mean, I need to look that up, but yeah.
I just saw
they always said they're waiting for spaceships to come pick them up or something.
If there's anybody from West Laco, tell Jax, what do you know about the
house in the corner of Texas and Expressway?
Right? Yeah.
Okay.
About Walmart. They never. Out. They refuse to sell to Walmart or to anybody.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's rich commercial.
It's right on the corner.
Real estate, right there. I mean, yeah.
Wow.
They make some money off of
and
that.
And where's it at?
In West Laco, at the corner of Texas. It's the northeast corner of Texas and the
frontage.
Expressway on the front.
Check it out.
Right
I'll
there.
Check it out,
yeah. It's all fenced with a private fence, and you see big trees. And
a lot of trees.
It's a compound. It's a compound. And they refuse to sell to Walmart. They refuse to sell to any commercial type of project. And I don't know why, but it's an interesting story. And it's one of those old tales.
Folk tales.
Stories that must not die.
Do we have anything else? You had another question?
Yeah, about for Raymond Horta as well, about the Bible prophecy. Do you think that right now we're living, it's coming from Tejano Historian, by the way, shout out. Do you think we're in the tribulation period right now with everything that is going on?
Yes, I believe that the tribulations have started. I do believe that.
What is a tribulation?
The
tampon shortages, bro.
The tampon shortage, the starving, there's going to be pestilence.
Like, okay, so I tampons
that's where the blood the river's going to come from.
Yeah, the rivers will run red with blood. The tampon shortage.
There you go.
Yeah. The tampon shortage.
The blood in the river.
The rivers will run red with blood.
It's all connected.
I love that.
Todo conectado, carnal. Está todo conectado.
Oh, my God.
Lean su Biblia, hombre. Lean su Biblia.
Hey,
oh my God, that was great.
And the baby formula shortage, the
locusts,
the smoke that went into the city and killed the unborn,
creeping death,
the firstborn, right?
Yeah,
Ramses.
Yeah, and unless you put a blood cross on your door,
yeah, you cover the door frame with the blood of the lamb.
Speaking of the cross on the door, they're asking here also the same person is saying, do you believe in the mark of the beast on your right hand or on your forehead?
Yes.
You know how they're doing the chips and stuff?
Yes, that's going to happen. That everything in the Bible has, like, the past prophecies have happened already. When Jesus, Yeshua, came by, he fulfilled 337 of them or more. And then the prophecies that he hasn't said or that haven't happened that he said were going to happen are unfolding right now. Like, I feel... that we're living in the end times. And,
the evil parents.
It's right there.
It
says in the Bible that in the end times, animals will start attacking humans just like that.
Hey, beware.
And this is something you all aren't talking about either, is the drought. Las Vegas, Nevada, Lake Mead is like drying up.
Oh, yeah.
Dead bodies are surfacing that we're missing for so many in barrels. Yeah. There's a spout that sucks the water that's above the water. so it's no longer capable of sucking water and servicing Southern California, where there's millions of people. So they're having a big drought. And then there's another area in Utah.
The Rio Grande stopped
shortage.
There's the Rio Grande, mm-hmm. It stopped flowing in Del Rio.
Back in the 80s, I was watching PBS, Channel 60, when it was good, you know, when it was fair, it wasn't, biased or, you know, there wasn't propaganda. But they had five scientists, and they were talking about the year 2025. And I remember I was watching it. I was a teenager, and I was watching it. And they asked them about 2025 wars in that era. And they all said, there won't be wars for oil. There will be wars for water. Oh, and, you know, there's areas in the Middle East, like in Egypt, the Nile River. It runs down from one country to the next country. And that top country, if they start having a drought, they can block that water from going down and helping other people. And there could be a war over that. And then a while back, there was a disagreement between Mexico and the United States over how many acreage of water Mexico took for agriculture from our Lake Amistad or Lake Falcon Lake.
You know? Remember that.
And so I was like, I started freaking out. Oh, right. They're already debating and fighting for the water, the usage of the water. So the droughts, I know Midland and West Texas is going through some heavy duty stuff. So that's another thing to look out for, bro.
Droughts.
You know, droughts.
Hunger, disease.
Can I elaborate on that real quick, guys? Raymond, have you heard that China takes a lot of the United States water, clean water? That we, as the United States, have to pay China clean water every year for some shit. I don't know. Can you elaborate? Have you heard about that?
I've heard that we're giving them a bunch of stuff as far as we're giving them a lot of land, like in Detroit, where all the auto manufacturing plants are.
Uh-huh.
They drive up the crime and drive up the, just make it unlivable, and then all of a sudden they give the price. Now you can buy a house in Detroit for like $500.
Yeah,
and it's like includes the lot and the house. Because nobody wants to live there. So then you have all these Chinese workers wanting to come over here. They'll buy all that land, buy all those houses, and they're sitting right next to those plants. They got workers to work those plants, and now China has taken over the steel. What is the
automotive industry?
The automotive industry.
Well, I had heard that.
You heard that?
China, people from China, are buying ranches and land and agriculture.
There's
and,
there,
cattle.
Even Texas. Here in Texas,
I heard that.
They have a big piece of property next to one of the Air Force bases, I think, in San Antonio.
Mm-hmm.
And they have, like, I think, I want to say something like 10,000 acres or...
Yeah, real estate. That's what they do. Yeah. They don't have to, you know, conquer our country. They could just buy it. You know what I mean?
Con esto te digo todo, bro. Bill Gates has bought the most farmland... Out of anybody, he owns the most farmland in the entire earth right now. Mm-hmm. Bill Gates bought all the farmland, and now you see all these process plants that are being burned down, food shortages and all that stuff, and Bill Gates is going to have all that land, and he's going to be the dude that runs everything.
He who controls the food controls everything, I guess. Yep.
Well, you know, I mean, we'll see what happens. All I can say is y'all better prepare because there is a fertilizer deal that's going on because Ukraine and Russia supply a lot of fertilizer to the United States agriculture and farmers, and so now their farmers are paying a lot of money. It's like 400% over what they used to pay for fertilizer, and they're right now they're not harvesting the crops yet, and they'll be out by about August, September, October, and that's when they say that there's going to be some shit, bro.
The crops,
the price on food and all kinds of other stuff. So they're saying
the crops. Have you seen the farmers that are being paid to destroy their crops?
No, I haven't seen that.
The government is paying the farmers to destroy their crops.
Wow.
And just to destroy them. Here's the money. We're going to pay you more money
to destroy
the crops than you would make selling it.
And what's the whole idea behind that?
Food shortage, bro. They want to control the masses. They want to have people.
I don't think you can control the masses if there's a food shortage, because people that are hungry are going to do whatever it takes. They'll revolt, dude. They will revolt. There'll be a big old revolt here in the United States.
They're just going to revolt amongst each other. Mm-hmm. That's what they want. They want chaos in order to come down with the full force of the law.
Well, no, they'll go straight to the people leading this country right away. And then the people that were informing us as well.
I think a good solid tarring and feathering is in order.
Yeah.
Insurrection yeah. Part 2.
I don't know, man.
The new beginning.
A lot of stuff is going on behind the scenes.
Hey, Raymond, oh, I wanted to ask Raymond real quick. Hey, Raymond, do you believe that the Antichrist is already in action?
No.
Or do you feel like you know who he is, the Antichrist?
Haven't you seen The Omen?
He's probably a TikTok star.
So the Antichrist is supposed to come along and fool everybody.
Mario's like, when are they going to ask me a question?
Yeah.
Mario's next.
Mario no encarado.
I need to smoke after all this. I need to have a good time. I'm going to die in the next
Mario's
5 years.
Stressed out.
No, I got you, bro.
No trajo el perro Melo para que lo calmara.
Service dog.
No trajo Melo para que Melo le diera, cálmate, güey, no te
andes. Next time lo traemos.
My dog's going to start charging, bro, because my sister was like, I had a bad day at work and I hang out with Melo. And I was like, hombre, con
Rock. Psychiatrist.
So let's go back to Raymond. What were you saying, Raymond?
No, so the Antichrist is supposed to come and fool everyone, and they're supposed to believe in him for world peace.
Is he already here? Is he alive?
No, it's he's going to be in the area of Jerusalem and the holy cities, like the Middle East area. And he's going to be the dude that ushers in world peace. Y este vato is going to be able to do miracles, signs, and wonders to fool everyone. Here's how you know that it's not Christ. And Jesus gives us a warning. Take heed that no one deceives you. There will be a time where they say, lo, here is the Lord, or there he is, or he is over there. Do not go, for it is not me. You will know that it is him when the dead rise from the graves first. That's how you know it's the real thing, because you can't fake that. Okay? So when you see the dead rise from the graves, that's when you know, orale, it's about to go down. But the Antichrist, before that happens, is going to make it seem like he's back already. It's going to seem like the Antichrist is Christ, but he's not Christ. So it's going to make it seem like that's him, but it's going to fool everybody.
That's where I'm confused. Is he going to say that he's... Is he going to preach the...
He's going to preach in a way that goes against the Bible, where he's going to say something to the effect of, we don't have to follow the Ten Commandments anymore.
Okay. The true believers should know that.
The true believers will know, but everybody else will be like, you see, guys? We don't have to follow the law anymore. We just do whatever we want.
Yeah.
Oye, Mario.
But it's going to be a human being, or it's going to be an actual...
It's going to be a human being with superpowers. Y dice, when he calls upon for world peace, that's when their destruction will come.
Oye, Mario.
Yeah.
Are you a true believer, Mario?
I am a true believer, pero también I think I can always be more. But at the same time, like Raymond, he...
What does a true believer have to be or do?
That's the thing, bro, because I really don't believe in religion. And I think the Bible is a lot of a man.
Do you ever say, oh, my God?
I try to say, oh, my gosh.
Oh, okay. And you believe that the man? What were you saying right now?
I just have a problem. I think religion is very, very man-made. And I think also the Bible también is...
Manipulating
into, so I'm kind of religious, but it kind of benefits like my idea. Like I take a little bit of the good parts from every religion and just have my own, you know.
There you go.
But it just comes down to like knowing there's a higher power and being a good person and trying to, you know, just make the world better. That's pretty much the three things.
Vote for Mario. Yeah. 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 Congress. Congress.
That's right. We need people like you, Mario.
Myra and Mario together.
And on that and positive note, ladies and gentlemen, there's nothing that gin and juice can't take care of. We want to thank you all for joining our Moringa. We got to get... Oh, by the way, we didn't even bring the pizza. I bought pizza.
Me la traigo.
Tráetelo, carnal. Tráetelo, carnal. All right.
Ya pegaron los munchies.
Sí, man. Ahora sí. All this scary shit, man, made us hungry.
Jax is straight dripping, bro. Look at that.
Too much drip.
Too much drip for one man.
Raymond, before we leave, talk to us about what you do at the island, man.
Yeah, dude. So
heals people.
Yeah. Every Thursday, man, we have an awesome comedy show. I got a sweet gig there at the Isla Grande Beach Resort, where I bring in national touring comedians every week, Thursday, from 7 to 9 p.m. sharp. I think we're the only comedy show in the country that starts on time.
Is there a charge, or do people need to buy tickets, or is it free, or what?
I'm going
to
give you guys a hookup, man. If you guys follow my buddy TJ Boom Fishing, he's the sponsor. He buys all the tickets, and he gives them away just for the fans of that follow him on social media. But... my goal for the room is to just give, because right now it's really hard. People are struggling to pay gas. We're giving away a lot of tickets to the shows. I give away almost almost all the tickets that we that of the people that go,
yeah,
they're giveaways, but they're paid for by our proud sponsors. So I appreciate you guys, TJ Boom Fishing, and my buddy Tehuacan Mineral Water.
Orale.
Awesome, ooh, awesome. Nice.
Well, we're real, real proud of you, Raymond.
Thank you guys, and, hey, I appreciate you guys, man. All glory to the Most High, King of Kings.
Yeah, we're real proud of you, man. You've done a lot, and you've been sticking to the comedy forever, and you've made a living and a career, and you're just a very, very hardworking dude, man. I mean, you've never given it up, and you've made a lot of people happy and laughter, and it's just something that's really awesome. It's a great talent that you have, and you know, ladies and gentlemen, if
you
ever,
so much, man,
if you ever see Raymond is going to be in your area, go out and check him out, man. It's always a lot of fun.
Pineapple.
He was at an event in Pasadena that was.
Let's talk about that
yes,
one.
Yes, yeah, I want to know
Let's
about that.
Let's talk about that one, bro.
Yeah,
I'm good right now. I'm good right now.
Échame la pa acá, carnal. Ah, no, aquí hay. Aquí hay.
There's some right here. Yeah, it's.
Ah, yo no quiero ese. Yo quiero la thin crust.
Aren't they the same? Oh, that is pineapple.
Is that gluten free? Is
it? I'm always
everything. Is it gluten free?
Yeah.
Does it have soy? Soy hambre.
Ya está frío.
Let me see, let me see.
Oh, then, baby. Here yeah, dude. This past week or two weekends ago, I was doing a gig at a rodeo arena in Pasadena, Texas, for the homeless veterans of our country, raising money. Algo bueno, mm-hmm. Algo bueno. It's something good for a good cause. And it's been a while since I had a show where I had struggled, Papa,
mm-hmm.
Where I really had to really earn my money. And I had or where there was no crowd there. It would have been a really long while, bro. And this, estamos en una arena for 10,000 people. And están diciendo, no, there's gonna be thousands of people here. Llegale, you're gonna do some comedy right before the main band, and it's gonna be legit. You're gonna go up there in front of thousands of people. Nombre carnal, I go up right before I'm about to go up there, bro. I'm looking at the crowd. I'm looking in the parking lot, like thinking maybe they're lining, they're filing into the fairgrounds. Nombre no había nadie en bato. Maybe there was 100 people there the first night. 100 people in an arena filled that's made for 10,000,
oh
dude.
My.
Se siente solo, bro. You're like, oh, cómeme tierra. And then I was like thinking the next night, all right, well, the next night they're going to have some bigger artists.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be a bigger crowd. And they were telling me, no, but tomorrow you can perform before the main guys. You can perform again, man. We'll make up for it. And tomorrow's going to be the better night. Bro, the next night, mind you, it's an arena for 10,000 people. There was maybe 25 people there.
Wow, he
was so wow.
Woo!
Oh, wow.
Gotcha, bro. Gotcha.
What a promoter lost his ass.
No, hombre, bro. That the worst thing is it was for homeless veterans, bro. That's what
yeah,
like, that's, no veteran should be homeless, man. That sucks, man.
Man, I felt real bad for the people, dude, that were running the event, and they lost, like you said, they lost.
Who were the headliners? Who were the stars? Besides you, you know?
I know one of them, off the top of my head, I want to say something like the guy from Big and Rich, John Rich or something mm-hmm. like that.
And then mm-hmm. Josh Abbott.
And Josh Abbott. And then the Sweet Tea Trio. Puros country acts, bro. And they were thinking that they were going to bring in thousands of people.
No, hombre, hubieran metido los dos carnales.
Algo así, güey, Wally González.
You know,
crazy pimps.
No.
Algo así, mm-hmm. You know, something heavy duty.
Yeah,
bringing the people to party, you know, something like you know, los dos Gilbertos, los cadetes, or something.
Ya los dos Gilbertos no existen. That se murió Gilberto.
Pues pongan el CD nomás.
Los Gilitos,
Venomous,
Venomous,
Blind Justice,
Whiskey D,
los Cuates,
Whiskey D ahí. Tienen el senior party ahí, güey.
Hey, tenían 25 con Whiskey D, hubieran como 30. Ahí por ahí, no, fácil.
Yeah.
Yeah. 30,000.
There's 25 people on the arena floor, mm-hmm. right? Y está el stage altísimo, bro. This is the biggest stage I've ever been on. It's like 3 stories high for some odd reason. And for real, güey, neta, it's like I've never, you had to climb stairs, like 2-3 flights of stairs on the side. And there's 25 people in the arena floor. And the Sweet Tea Trio is playing for them with all he got, bro. All their heart is into it. Yo, I'm in the audience section just trying to get the crowd into it. Like, hey, after they finish playing.
Yeah. How's everybody doing? Doing.
You were the hype man. And I was like, yeah.
The hype man.
Yeah. And trying to get into it, right? Well, then they finish their set, and I go upstairs, and I'm about to go on stage, and they say, all right, guys, we're going to be doing a meet and greet over there on the side and selling our merch. If you guys care to take a picture with us, we'll be right over there. All 25 people away that were there watching the show, se fueron, vato. Oh, dang. And I was left there performing for two people. For two people in an arena of 10,000.
No. On a skyscraper.
The stacks that they use for those big festivals, those big speaker stacks, were like, I mean, it was like Metallica was playing with. Yeah, y estoy diciendo jokes. Hey, so what's going on, guys? I'm from La Jolla.
Right? And then the crowd barricade.
Yeah. And then on top of that, they even had speakers. Like the rodeo arenas have these tin roofs over them, right? And they had speakers on the tin roof on the inside, so se oía el echo de mi joke bombing twice back to back.
Oye, bro.
I was praying for the rapture. Llévame, por favor, Dios. Llévame ahorita, por favor, Dios.
This is the tribulation.
This is the tribulation. Te dije, the tribulations are right now.
Oye, bro, una vez tocamos allá en el Stock Show Ground, and antes de nosotros ponieron un death metal band por un hour. An hour and a half, bro.
Oh.
Yeah, I was terrible.
Like unholy desecration.
All right, then we're gonna do another song.
And it's like monster bands.
They have these little stories.
And for our final song,
this is a song that I wrote for my grandma. It's called "Drenched in Gasoline."
Yeah,
this is a song called "Anal Leakage."
Hey, bro! By the end of their set, there was like five people, bro.
They walked everybody.
Everybody left, bro.
No,
and we were headlining, bro. So we went up on stage. Dimos fucking 90 minutes, carnal, por un pinche jazz, carnal, y había como 3, 4, 5 personas ahí enfrente, bro. And we finished playing, thank you, good night. And then we turn around and we're like, fuck. And this night's over, finally. He's like, one more. One more. One more.
Serious. One more. On video.
Rally was there, bro.
Yeah, and we so had it on video.
The three people started going, one more, one more.
Are you sure they weren't saying, one of us, one of us? Keeble, gobble, keeble, gobble.
No, bro. So then I look at the bass player, I look at the rest of the band, and we're like, what the fuck, bro? Fuck it, let's do one more.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Hell yeah.
This is how I know I did it. I hadn't had one of these. Wait, this is how you know you like as a comedian. It does the kick in the nuts, bro. Right here, these two dudes come to me after the show, and they're like, "Hey, I just want to shake your hand, man." And I reach my hand and go, and I when I shook my their hand, they go, "Way to take it like a man, bro."
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us tonight. We appreciate it.
Oh, my God.
Oh, damn.
Jesus.
That concludes this week's episode.
Me pasó yo con los dabs.
Y eso es todo el pepperoni para agarrar.
Eso es monkeypox.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us today. We had a fun time.
Oh,
Mario,
it's already 2 hours, bro.
2 hours.
I didn't even get to talk about David Olivares, bro.
Nada, we've seen. No way.
Hey, you guys are going to come back. You guys will come back.
I love that dude, bro. He walked people, but for the good reason. And I stayed up there performing for two people after he did El Soñador 4 times in his set, bro.
Hey, wait.
No. Killing it each time.
Hey, wait.
It's 4 times, wait. El Soñador.
For 4 people?
No, there was chingos of people. Oh, but then okay. He got off to do a meet and greet también y me dejó con dos people.
Oh.
Con dos personas también, wey.
Oh, dark crowd.
Sí, también.
El vato hizo play su hit 4 times in El Soñador. En el set, wey.
Yeah. Yeah. He started off with it, he middled with it, and he did 2 encores with it.
¡Otra vez! ¡Otra vez! Pues vamos a poner la misma.
Hey, puso la rola en loop. Thank you so much, Mario and Raymond. Thank you for joining us tonight on hashtag PBT The Rock and Chat Show. And tomorrow night, we have another show going to be live. We got a very important guest tomorrow, so be sure to join us. And tell all your friends, like, share, and subscribe, man. You all wave at the camera, man. We're gone.